ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಸರಸ್ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಜನ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ನಿರತಂ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಚಿನ್ಮಯಂ ದೇವಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ. ಓಂ ಶುಕ್ಲಾಂಬರಧರಂ ವಿಷ್ಣುಂ ಶಶಿವರ್ಣಂ ಚತುರ್ಭುಜಂ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನವದನಂ ಧ್ಯಾಯೇತ್ ಸರ್ವವಿಘ್ನೋಪಶಾಂತಯೇ. ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ವಸಿಷ್ಠ ಪರಾಶರಾತ್ಮಜಂ ವಂದೇ ಶುಕತಾತಂ ತಪೋನಿಧಿಂ. ವ್ಯಾಸಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣುರೂಪಾಯ ವ್ಯಾಸರೂಪಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣವೇ ನಮೋ ವೈ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ನಿಧಯೇ ವಾಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ. ವಸುದೇವಸುತಂ ದೇವಂ ಕಂಸಚಾಣೂರಮರ್ದನಂ ದೇವಕೀ ಪರಮಾನಂದಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ. ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂ ಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್. ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ಮಹಾವ್ರತಾಯ ಪರಾಶರಂ ವೇದನಿಧಿಂ ನಮಸ್ಯೇ. ನಮೋಸ್ತ್ವನಂತಾಯ ಮಹೋರಗಾಯ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಸಿದ್ಧೇಭ್ಯ ಇಹಾಕ್ಷಯೇಭ್ಯಃ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಋಷಿಭ್ಯ ಪರಮಂ ಪರೇಶಾಂ ದೇವೇಷು ದೇವಂ ವರದಂ ವರಾಣಾಂ ಸಹಸ್ರಶೀರ್ಷಾಯ ನಮಃ ಶಿವಾಯ ಸಹಸ್ರನಾಮಾಯ ಜನಾರ್ದನಾಯ.
So having heard about Agastya Rishi and Parashuramji's incident, we used to ask it, please, something I want to listen more about Agastya Rishi. Kindly tell me. So Lomasji continues the story. He says, Agastya's charitra divyam, divine, wonderful, adbhutam, ati manushim. It is something extraordinary. His provas, prabhava, is very great. So, Agastyasya Maharaja, prabhavam ati taujasaha. Prabhavam also, provas also is very, very great. So, please listen to me. His one of his, another glories, one of the glories of Agastya Rishi. In Satya Yuga, there were host of Rakshasas, Daityas, by name of Kalakeya. Kalakeyas, they are called Kalakeya. Dark forces in the cosmos who disturb the life around. They were very cruel in their swabhav, ati cruel. So what this Kalakeya did, they all went to Vritrasura and they formed a big group under his leadership, Vritrasura leadership. And jhagada karne mein unmatta, matta pramatta, they were really intoxicated to fight with devatas. Kalakeya forces under the leadership of Vritrasura. So what did they do? They attacked all the devatas including Indra, and all gods went to Brahmaji for support, creator. So Brahmaji said, ab dekhiye Vritrasura ko marna ho to you all go to Dadichi Maharishi and ask for his bones. The weapon made up of the bones of Dadichi Maharishi would destroy Vritrasura. To unke paas jaake you must take his bones. So all of you go to Dadichi Maharishi, request him to leave his body. अब अपन आप हमको आपका शरीर चाहिए छोड़ दीजिए एंड टेक हिज बोन्स एंड मेक वज्र आउट ऑफ हिज बोन्स एंड दैट वज्रायुध एंड आउट ऑफ दैट यू कैन डिस्ट्रॉय रुद्रासुर. तो उन्होंने क्या किया, ऑल द गॉड्स वेंट टू दधीच ऋषि. When his ashram so beautiful described, filled with fruits and beautiful trees, fruits and flowers, it was like another heaven. So the daityas went, they saw Dadija Maharishi in a more splendorous form, shining like the another sun himself, the light of tapas. So they requested, sir, that is a problem, so we need your bones. So kindly give up your physical body. So Dadichi accepted because it's for daiva karyam, and he left his body instantly, immediately chhod ke chala gaya. And gods took his bones and went to Tvastha Prajapati with the bones. So they requested Tvastha Prajapati to make a vajrayudha. So he made a powerful weapon out of those bones, and he told Indra, this will डिस्ट्रॉय रुद्रासुर, आज ही आप इसका प्रयोग कर दीजिएगा, तुरंत उसका वध हो जाएगा, नो प्रॉब्लम, टेक इट. सो इंद्र वॉज वेरी हैप्पी एंड ही टुक दैट वेपन मेड बाय त्वस्ट आउट ऑफ दधीचीज बोन्स एंड दे लेफ्ट, ही टुक इट. नो इंद्र वेंट रुद्रासुर. Rudrasura, what did he do? He covered the whole earth, both earth and heaven, with his influence. Encircled. Rudra means? What does it mean, Rudra? Circle only. We'll see about Rudrasura. All of us have Rudrasura in us. So, Kalake Daityas, these dark forces, they are all standing around protecting Rudrasura. Rudrasura himself is Bhayankara. So the Kalakaya forces encircled him, protecting Rudrasura. So there's a huge fight between Indra and Daityas. And it became difficult for Devatas to stand in front of Rudrasura to put up their fight against Daityas. And when they were fighting, Devatas started running helter-skelter, here and there. Indra also was disillusioned himself. Looking at Rudrasura's powers, he was really shocked, and he came under the spell of delusion. Looking at Rudrasura's power, he was so scared and ran towards Bhagavan Vishnu. Because you know, Vajrayudha you have, but uska prayog karne ke liye pehle tumko wahan kada hona hoga. Kada rehne se hota hai na, kada rehne mein mushkil ho raha hai. Very powerful. So Lord Vishnu placed in Indra his power. Brahmarshis are there. They also gave their power to Vishnu in Indra, their Shakti. And when everybody, Maharshis, Rishis, Brahmarshis, plus Brahmaji, I mean Vishnu Bhagavan, all of them gave their Shakti powers put in Indra, with that Indra became very powerful, even to stand before Rudrasura. And with all the blessings of Bhagavan Vishnu and Maharshis, Indra released his Vajra and killed Rudrasura. And when Rudrasura was killed, rest of the Kalakaya forces ran away from the war field in self-protection, and they hid themselves in the ocean. Now, who is Rudrasura? See, Rudrasura means, Vritta means what? Circle, round. There is Rudrasura in us, wherein any negativity in the mind and intellect, any negativity you take, that which puts a spell of delusion over your mind and intellect. Intellect especially, buddhi ko it covers, mind also mohit karke, buddhi ko bhi, jnana ko avratam, etena avratam jnanam. What Rudrasura? Our own things, which those habits, tendencies, desires, concepts, ideologies, बार बार जो हमारे पास आते हैं, that is called Rudra. You cannot get rid of it. Oh, साल 20 साल 25 साल के बाद फिर वही वासना फिर निकलती है. Maybe kama vasana, krodha vasana, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya, irsya, dvesha, asuya, raga, enmity. Vrutram is again and again they come and stand before you. And it is protected by dark forces within ourselves. And we only empower them by acting as a host. By forcibly driving them, they don't go. They don't go. So Vrutrasura, each one of us have to destroy Vrutrasura. Now, Vrutrasura at the cosmic level, Indra had to face, that was in himself. And he had to fight. And each one of us have Vrutrasura in our own mind, in our personality, that each one of us have to fight. So, certain habits, certain negativity, tendencies, certain bimariya, you know, bar bar jo aate hain, not only at a physical level, but mental level and intellectual level I'm talking. Somehow we cannot get away out of that block. This is called Rudrasura. Log bolte hain na, main samajhti hoon ya samajhta hoon ki gussa teek nahi hai vyakti ke liye, phir bhi bar bar aati hai. Rudrasura number one. Rudrasura number two. Desire. Haan, mai toh some diabetic patient eating sweets. Rudrasura attacks. BP patient running after Andhra pickles. Rudrasura attacks. Salty. Think. You know. But the dark forces are protecting the Rudrasura. So whenever you want to get rid of the Rudrasura from us, these forces attack us. First, they don't let us go and deal with the problem. What are the negative forces? Those, whenever you wanted to, I don't know if you're conscious or not, whenever you want to apply some formula on your mind, immediately mind tries to escape by giving you some suggestions which are actually not related to your work. It's very tough. That which you are convinced of intellectually, totally, when you want to implement it, somehow mind misguides you. Who are those forces which misguide you? Oh, temple jate samay, temple ke Bhagwan ke mandir mein, and if you don't want to escape, when escape that, somehow thought, you know, comes that यहाँ तक तो आया है तो ठीक है, फिर कल आएंगे, आज तो बहुत भीड़ है मंदिर में, कर जाऊँ, चलो जाओ, सो जाएंगे. और लौटते समय दैट द फर्स्ट अटैक ऑफ डार्क फोर्सेस, लौटते समय दैट डार्क अनदर डार्क फोर्स विल फर्दर मिस, बिकॉज दे हैव अ टीम वर्क, दे मिस गाइड यू एंड टेक यू टू अ होटल और अ मूवी और अ फ्रेंड्स हाउस. तो सत्संग के लिए निकलते हैं घर से मगर यहाँ नहीं पहुंचते, मगर जहां पर सत्संग वहां नहीं पहुंचते, बीच में और कोई में वहां उनके साथ जाते हैं. That means this Vrutrasura, the disease which is reprooted, is protected by immediate negative forces in us which misguide us, which take us away from the goal. It doesn't allow us to tackle the core problem or core issue. Who is the core issue? Vrutrasura. What is Uttarasura? Those vruttam, meaning again and again they come and haunt us. So all of us have Uttarasura. And Uttarasura deludes. Indra was deluded. So we, the personality, deludes. The inner jiva, the individual gets deluded. And therefore, even though you are provided with Vajrayudha in terms of secrets, knowledge, path, conviction. अब बताइए, हमें सब है, विमान है, पेट्रोल भरा हुआ है, फ्लाइट अंडर परफेक्ट कंडीशन, एवरीथिंग इज देयर, टेक ऑफ नेवर हैपेंस. थिंक, टेक ऑफ नेवर टेक्स प्लेस. सो इन अस दोज डार्क फोर्सेस अगेन एंड अगेन स्टॉप. दिस इज वृत्रासुर. And when the core Vritrasura is killed, this now you want understood, and he has been destroyed with the help of the blessings of Vishnu and Brahmarshis. When they gave their tejas, their sankalpa shakti, when they invoke their power for our winning with their blessings, with their sankalpa, because master's wish works. So it is not that our sankalpa works. It is somebody else's sankalpa that we should go to satsanga. It is happening. Think that. It is not my sankalpa that I speak. It is somebody else's sankalpa, that guru's sankalpa, which is making me to speak. That means, given a choice, I will not speak. Given a freedom, you will not come for satsanga. So, these around me, whatever good sadhana I am doing, sadhana means sadhana good only, whatever good that I am doing, whatever sadhana that I am doing, is in fact, is because of the tejas planted in me, teja planted in me, by the rishis, the gurus, the Bhagavan. So it is their sankalpa which is working through us. That means we have the power in me, yet I am not able to execute it. Because something is missing. So even though I have gained knowledge, understanding about the path, map is clear, everything is clear, plus the master's blessing, if they are not there, I don't move. So they are added. So Vishnu, Indra ran to Vishnu for support. So they placed their tejas in Indra to win against his Vritrasura. So bar bar aake disturbing the cosmic work at the cosmic level. At individual level, they disturb our individual work at individual level. You fed up and give up ultimately. Give up yourself to that Vritrasura. Vritrasura wins ultimately. So, and these people, dark forces, what they do? When you are able to attack, the main things are removed from you. These negative forces, little forces which have been tempting you, small things. For example, I am telling you that if you don't have a desire to construct the house itself, which is like Vritrasura, bar bar aati hai. For example, I am giving you. Not that every desire to construct the house is a Vritrasura, I am just giving an example. Suppose you don't have, but again that and again it comes and disturbs you. Example I am giving you. Now, when that desire is rooted out, but there is no more desire for you to have your own property or possession or house, the desire is removed, when sub desires also would go away and disappear, is it not? Think. For example, I tell you, you constructed a house and you forgot to construct a car shed. Now, when you forget to construct a car shed in your own house, and later on to construct car shed impossible because it's a flat and a congested bailey and no chance for you, and you have to park your car on your. So tab kya hota hai? When you constructed the house, you had no desire for car. Though the thought came, you brush it aside. But afterwards, even though you have a house and all, this you don't have a car garage or car parking place in your house. This keeps on haunting you as long as you live. Practical example I'm telling you. Even though you may give up the bigger desire for house, but the desire, and then what happened? The small desire will come and say, had you purchased a house on that day, at least you would have got the car by now. That means कार के लिए घर, अब देखिए उल्टा चल रहा है कि नहीं। कार लेना हो कहां रखेंगे, अपना घर चाहिए तो घर सेकेंडरी, फर्स्ट कार, कार के लिए घर, मतलब छोटे के लिए बड़ा। दिस इज स्मॉल डार्क फोर्सेस। व्हेन द बिग डिजायर इज डिसअपीयर्ड, व्हेन द स्मॉल डिजायर्स आल्सो डिसअपीयर, बट दे आर नॉट डेड, दे आर हिडन इन द डीप ओशन ऑफ द वॉटर्स ऑफ अवर ओन चित्त। तो बार बार आते हैं, वेरी फनी। सो दिस कालकेय फोर्सेस, डार्क फोर्सेस, दे आर नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड, दे आर हिडन इन द ओशन। नाउ इन द कॉस्मिक लेवल दे वेंट एंड हिट देमसेल्व्स इन द ओशन। So because in every applicability of our every shastra, we would apply it adhidhaivika, adhyatmika and adhibhautika. Adhibhautika level also is there, adhyatmika level also is there, and adhidhaivika level also is there. So these all the three need to be applied. So Vrutrasura means you don't keep listen, Vrutrasura was there somewhere, a force and all. No, it is actually inside. Indra also faced at the cosmic level. And we are to also face at our own level. Rutrasura is there. And Kalakaya forces protecting the main Rutrasura, they are all surrounding that forces. They are there. Understood, no? Big desire and small desire. And big desire may be given up, but the small desires would always remind us, stating that, had you fulfilled the big desire, I would have also got chance to fulfill myself. So you want to have a music system, for example. Simple, say, smaller desire. And that music system cannot be placed anywhere unless you have a good cupboard or place is required. And place you cannot get in a rented house. And therefore the youth mind says that you go and occupy a bigger house. For what? For music system. Now you don't tell me such bevukuf log nahi hai duniya mein. Bevukuf log hi hai duniya mein. You don't tell me that now. How many people are there? So when you really think about Uttarasura and dark forces and Kalakaya forces, it's true. So Indra ultimately killed. When Indra killed Uttarasura, Uttarasura was killed. The dark force disappeared. And what did they do? They had a meeting separately. What was the meeting? They discussed minutes of meeting, agenda. They released their minutes of meeting also. What they decided is that some of them gave an idea that first of all, we have to kill all wise people and also tapasvis on earth. That is their point number one. Like terrorist attack at parliament. Saath mein sabhi ko udayenge. So immediately country will be in chaos. No Prime Minister, the MPs and MLAs, ministers, everybody will be off. Then we can try to do some kind of a, because administration, power, police, everything goes out of order. Nobody will be there to give orders. So they had a meeting. And because, why? Because tapasvis, all lokas exist in tapas. So the tapas should be stopped. By whom? By killing tapasvis, those who are performing penance. Unko pehle maar dalenge. Hence, if they are killed, all lokas will suffer terribly, and therefore all deityas came to this conclusion, and without any fear, they have resided in the deep ocean. Why? It is difficult to fish them out. In the mind only, so many desires are there. They are so hidden deep in us. Which desire, when it would come out, we don't know. They are deep desires in us. That's why we see sudden crime perpetrated by people. What you call looting, arson, plundering, killing. Sudden. All of a sudden. This is Sajjan, Mahatma. You feel that way, then again immediately next day you read a report. I mean, this, you are helpless. The individual is helpless because discrimination is lost. It is entirely clouded, and the chitta may, in the ocean of the chitta, deep hidden, the desires suddenly spring and attack you. They don't give you time to think. That is the strategy. It has always been a strategy of enemies. Don't give time to think. They should be confused. Put them in confusion and attack the countries. So the Kalake Daitya started destroying all the worlds. They started attacking ashramas, other punya places, merit pilgrim place, etc. in the nights, and they caused destruction. Din mein nahi aate bahar, night mein aa jao, satyanash karke, again the forces used to hidden themselves in the ocean. And morning when you see horrible situations around. Blood is lying down, bones are lying down there, and majja, mansa, asti, destroyed. So all they, in the early hours, many used to see the death of all their students in the premise of that. Gurus used to see apne chelon ka raat mein pad ke so gaye, Vedanta Veda abhyas karke, next day morning they saw the dead bodies. So used to suck all the blood, these daityas, and eat the flesh and leave the bones there. It was a site of destruction. Homakunda were destroyed. They scattered yajnapatras day and night. In the sense, lagatar, they engaged in these activities. And Indra and other devatas used to have their regular meetings to contract this problem. Then all of them approached Vishnu. They prayed to Vishnu to protect Indra from these daityas. Then our Vishnu Bhagavan said, daityas prayed to Vishnu, and Vishnu Bhagavan said, I know all the problems. Please listen to me carefully. There is a one group called group of daityas called Kalakeyas. They are very powerful, and they are creating all these huge loss of lives, destroying all the three worlds. Why? They are unable to bear the death of Dhritarashtra. Because of that, they are engaging in these activities. So, and they are now presently hidden in the deep waters because none of them knew who is doing all this. Like guerrilla war. Abhi guerrilla war, we have crossed all those, we further evolved. Direct suicide attack only. Bomb dikha ke apne aap phodte hain. I am going to kill myself and kill you people also. Guerrilla war had gone. So, guerrilla war. Now, they coming out in the nights and causing all the disturbance, and it is not possible to kill them when they are hiding in the ocean, Bhagavan Vishnu said. So you must first empty the ocean. Who empty the ocean? Who? Vishnu said, go to Agastya Rishi. He is capable of drinking the oceanic waters. It dries up everything. And without doing this, daityas will not come under control. So all gods went to Brahmaji and they took permission first. Otherwise, you know, you are interfering in creation. Kisi ko bula ke paani pila raha hai, pura ocean. Brahmaji should know in this creation, kya ho raha hai karke. So they took permission from Brahmaji. Hum aisa karne ja raha hai, we are now requesting. Brahmaji gave permission. Then all of them went. First they praised Agastya Rishi. They prostrated, praised, saluted. Then Devata said to Agastya Rishi, Maharaj, in the past, you alone protected us from the misbehavior of King Nahusha. You know Nahusha Chakravarti, we saw the story, palanquin. And he used to ask Sapta Rishis to carry the palanquin every day. And Bhrugu and Agastya thought, we must, so they were, so Agastya is shot, palanquin was not moving, who is got angry, and then he, Nahusha was cursed and he became as a serpent on the globe, and he fell down from heaven. So you protected from Nahusha Chakravarti. His, when he became Indra, when the other Indra was hidden somewhere, all that story we saw in Mahabharata. Now I cannot repeat everything. So then they praised that you alone again protected us from problem of Vindhya mountains. I told you Vindhya mountain. When he was going, Vindhya is rising and that also. And you have been a great protector of devatas during different problematic situations. Now again the problem has come. Please protect us. Well, Vindhya Mountains said, Yudhishthira said, why, what was the problem with Vindhya Mountain? I don't know about this. Please tell the story of Vindhya Mountain also, he said. The story can the story. So Lomashi says, why did he get angry? Agastya Rishi, why was Vindhya Mountain misbehaved? What was the problem? What was the cause? Please tell me that. Lomasa started. Bhagavan Surya Narayana always circumambulates protection at dusk around Meru Parvata. Meru, now I cannot describe it, everything. It is not a small mountain. It is in Brahmanda. It is an axis, central axis, and you draw a triangle. And so this central axis is central, passing through central solar system, Sudri Manigana Yoga, and the Surya Bhagavan actually when goes round and round the entire Meru Parvata, and that is his path as a respect to the entire central thing. And every sun is does the same thing towards the central pillar which runs through certain lokas. So Surya Bhagavan does pradakshina to that. Solar system circulates around him. All solar systems go round and round and round. The center of the universe. And that center, like a sphere you take from the top to north pole to south pole, if you draw a line, that becomes axis. That axis is again a triangle and covering all the lokas. It is a Meru Parvata in Shastras, in secret language. It is not a mitti, it's a manavatra mountain going in. Now, there what happened? When sun circumambulates that pradakshina around Meru Parvata, one day Vindhya Mountain got noticed this. Why he is respecting and going round and round Meru? Why can't he also put namaskar to me and go round me also? Respect me. Whether you are a small or not, insignificant maybe in the creation, but you can demand respect as equal to Brahmaji himself. That's why great masters have said, before you want to be praised and honored, become praiseworthy. Honor worthy. Gharon mein kuch nahi hai and I want praise from everybody. Tumhe kya hai? Kshamata nahi hai. Gussa kub hai. What is it we have that we should be respected at home, in the families, in the societies, in the flats, in the associations? What is that we have? But I can demand respect all over the cosmos. Vindhya did same thing. So Bhaskara, you also, you pradakshana, you do Meru Mountain. Similarly, you go around me also. Bhaskara said, Maharaj, I am not doing pradakshana to Meru Parvata as per my wish. This is the path ordained to me by Creator. It's an orbit. I have to go and stick to the orbit, and on the orbit of my orbit, solar system orbit, I am going round. It is not that I, per my wish, I am going round on Bhagal Jaisa, Pradakshana. It is my path in the cosmos. So, I can't do anything like this. So, listening, Vindhya got very wild and he started growing, blocking the way of Surya and Chandra. Meaning, if the mountain is growing in size, naturally the shadow covers large part of the place. It is actually stopping the Surya Gati only and creating or hampering the life on the earth. This is what he has been doing. So it is a protruding into space. That is horrible. So all gods went to Vindhya Mountain and appealed, Maisa Maharaj, aisa mat karo, because life is surviving. You should not do all these things. Please calm down. But all their efforts were of no use. Then all the gods went to Agastya Rishi and presented to him this problem. Hey, padte ja rahe. Agastya Rishi with Lopa Mudra at that time, he settled himself in Varanasi, thinking that I will settle myself in Varanasi, praying to Lord Shiva and tapas. When gods requested, Agastya said, okay, I will do something. So both of them went with Lopamudra started walking towards Madhya Pradesh only, Vindhya. So, Vindhya chala. And then Vindhya was too huge and Agastya is short, no? So, Agastya said, I am very short, I cannot cross, so kindly bend. If you bend, I can cross. Too tall. Maharshi. So, Vindhya accepted, said, okay, I am going towards south. Till I come back, be like this only. Vindhya accepted. Agastya went and never returned. Is that's why his ashrama, his place of abode is Tamil Nadu. Agastya Rishi only gave Tamil Bhasha also. So Tamil Nadu mein baith gaya. Agastya Rishi. There's Agastya. Therefore, Tamil Nadu mein Agastya temples. In every temple you see Agastya statue, most of the temples. So that is how the story goes on, Lomasha told. And now listen to me, how Agastya helped Devatas in killing Kalakai Rakshasas. You asked about Vindhya mountain, I told you. Now, when gods approached Agastya for this problem, and they told that the ocean should be dried up. Agastya said, okay, mujhe kya karna batao? Aap paani pi lena, samudra water. And he dried up entire samudra. Drank means not with the drank mouth. With his tejas and tapas, he dried up the ocean. Ocean became dried. With the agni, tapas, tapo agni. Everything dried up. And it also points out, not only this one, there is also, I read, Mahatma said, somebody said, that this Agastya, somewhere representing a star in the cosmos, came closer to my earth for some time back in the long back, and it dried up oceans because of the atmospheric heat. That was also a cosmic plan, so that the certain things can be replaced, replenished, all those things. So Agastya drank the ocean. Agastya Rishi did this sankalpa, and then all gods went to Samudra, many human beings, Naga, Gandharva, Yaksha, Kinnaras came to see that wonder, and he drank the entire ocean, Bhagavad said, and whole ocean he drank. Devatas attacked Daityas because they came out, now surfaced, they could not hide themselves. That's why in our life also, in some cases, you know, when Kalakaya forces are so dark, hidden, and they are not brought out so easily, the treatment is nature gives a shock. Suppose a person who is extraordinarily arrogant, superior complex, and he created a shell and he is residing in the shell. It really happens, literally happens. So he is disrespects everybody in the world, elder, youngster. He feels something is unique creature, special, very great. And no one is able to break that shell of his arrogance. How would he come out? Nature gives him a shock. So physically, the nature makes that person crippled. Anyone. When you accident take place, you become dependent, the entire personality shakes. In that, dark things will come out. And in the light of this service which is receiving, and the pain that is undergoing, and because of that, the intellect is now turned towards him. Little Roshni Ai Andar. In that Roshni, he would see his own flaws, and they gave up. He gives up. That is why many people change when shock takes place, shock treatment. Ek bar shock lag gai jeevan mein, ekdam astik ban jata hai. Jai bolo naad ki, jai. Till then, we don't change. Mother-in-laws don't change. Daughters-in-law don't change. Fathers-in-law don't change. Till they receive shock. Shock mil jane ke baad, aadmi mein parivartan aate. In relationship, brothers don't change. Sisters don't. Unless some shock we must get. Once we get shock, we are jolted. In the jolt, we are switched out. So, there is no other way. Dark forces in chitta are so hidden. I put them in shell. Shell has to be broken. To break the shell, shock has to be given. Simply you scratch the shell, nothing will happen. So this is what the great teacher says. Now, then afterwards, all the deities are killed and gods told, sir, very happy. You have done. We have done our job. Kindly put back the waters into the ocean. He said, "Abhi kahan ka pani pura digest ho gaya bol diya." Now they were shocked. What? You can't bring them out? He said, "I already digested the ocean. I drank the entire ocean, digested." And Agastya said, "Now devatas, you all think of other means to fill the ocean with waters again, the land. अभी अपना दूसरा उपाय ढूंढो." देवता सर एक मुसीबत हट गए तो दूसरे मुसीबत आ गए. अभी नाउ बिग प्रॉब्लम. नो, दिस इज अ प्रॉब्लम्स दैट कॉस्मिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर्स फेस. अब ये कैसा है? नाउ दे ऑल वेंट टू, नो अदर ऑप्शन, वेंट टू विष्णु भगवान. भगवान आपने बताया उनके पास जाओ, वो पानी पूरा पी लिया, काम तो हो गया, अभी दूसरे मुसीबत आ गए. He says, no, I digested the oceanic waters, nothing, oceans are not, without water on the earth, now how you can survive? Well, rivers, you know, how many years, millions of years it will take to fill the oceanic waters with the waters again? कितना हो सकता है? इतना जल पृथ्वी पर पड़ा है, suddenly you dried up. क्या होगा? सो लेटर ऑन दे ऑल वेंट टू ब्रह्माजी. देन विष्णुमान से गोल्डनाथ ब्रह्माजी विल सजेस्ट. सो ब्रह्माजी सेड ए मीन्स टू फिल द ओशन. विष्णु सेड गो, ही विल सजेस्ट ए मीन्स. सो ब्रह्माजी वॉज रिक्वेस्टेड, प्लीज सजेस्ट सम अदर मीन्स नाउ टू फिल द ओशन वॉटर्स नाउ. Otherwise, no beings again can survive. Not only human beings and plants, animals on the earth, but also devatas. Cosmic cycle may some functions become dysfunctional. He said, gods, Brahmaji told to the gods, mere bete, sun lo aap log abhi. All of you go back to your respective places now. Mera dimag mat khana. Abhi immediately aapka ye kaam nahi hoga. It's again long time from now that you will see the ocean with full waters. काफी समय लग जाता है, अभी नहीं होगा. Why? Long time from now, after long time, King Bhagiratha, in order to liberate his ancestors, he would fill all these oceans again with waters. That means, in this long, even don't depend on this history and 2000 history, 10,000 history and all that. In the long cosmic history, there was a time where the water had to be materialized on earth again, step by step. It has to be materialized on Prithvi. So to bring the waters which are existing in Prakriti, to materialize it, to bring to this plane of materialization, physical plane, a parampara, a rishi parampara worked hard for this. Many kings have struggled, they did little tapas, subsequently, like a discovery, one scientist discovers, dies, discovery is further continued. Like that, many kings have struggled to materialize again this water on earth. There was a water little bit, but then it is not enough. It's all very deep science. So, devatas returned back to their abodes, waiting for Bhagiratha. So, Yudhishthira asked another question. Sir, how come the ancestors of Bhagiratha, they became a cause in filling up the ocean? Bhagiratha ke purvi log, ancestors, pitros. अरे ओशन भरने में जिस समुद्र भरने में वो लोग कारण बन गए. कैसे बन गए कारण? दे बिकेम निमित्त. हाउ डिड दे बिकेम निमित्त? हाउ ओशंस बिकेम फुल विद द सपोर्ट ऑफ भगीरथ? यू प्लीज टेल मी. एंड व्हाट वाज द कॉज फॉर इट, फॉर देयर पृथ्वी पीपल एंसेस्टर्स टू सफर? यू प्लीज टेल मी द डिटेल्स नाउ कंप्लीटली. सो नाउ सागर चरित्र बिगिन्स. Now we are understanding so many stories that we are going through. Now, Sagara Charitra. So, I won't listen to it exhaustively. Explain. Then Lomasha Maharshi explained about the King Sagara, greatness of Sagara Charitra. Sagara. King Sagara, how he, what do you call, ruled earth and all that. So, he continued. There was a king by name Sagara in the Ikshvaku dynasty. Ikshvaku Kula. And he was a very strong, courageous, this King Sagara, very smart to look. But he had no children. So he brought Aiheya and Talajangha kingdoms, the kingdoms under his control, and started ruling those kingdoms also. Various kingdoms he conquered. He had two wives. One is Vaidarbhi, other is Shaibhya. Sagara's two wives, Vaidarbhi and Shaibhya. And these two queens were very proud of their beauty. They must have contested there at that time also. Beauty contest. So they were always proud of their beauty. This king Sagara went to Kailasha Parvata along with his wives and did perform a great tapas, seeking Lord Shiva's blessings for progeny. Lord Shiva appeared and said, what do you want? He said, give me a son. I mean children. So Bhagavan said, the time at which or during which you asked the boon, jab manga na, तो मांगते समय जो काला काल विशेष होता है ना, डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट टाइम इट विल यील्ड द फॉलोइंग रिजल्ट्स. व्हाट आर द फॉलोइंग रिजल्ट्स? थ्रू वन ऑफ योर वाइव्स यू विल गेट 60,000 सन्स हु विल बी फुल ऑफ प्राइड, विल वेरी प्राउड, एंड ऑल ऑफ देम वुड गेट किल्ड एट वंस. 60,000 चिल्ड्रन. And it is like a, not like a one by one from the womb. All the seed, like a Kauravas are born, that is the process, scientific process were born that time. 60,000 born, everybody came out. So that is one thing. Then through other wife, you will get only one valorous son. Saying this, Bhagavan Shiva disappeared. Chalo yoga. After some time, Vaidarbhi gave birth to a flesh god, G-O-U-R-D, you know. Uske pind, maansa pind samajh leje. Like a bottle god, snake god. This is maansa pind, janam diya. Shaibhya gave birth to a beautiful son. Now, Raja thought, why this maansa pind is like a stillborn, not even stillborn, like a flesh born. So, I will throw this. That time, Akashvani said, no, don't do, O Sagara. Why? It's like a pumpkin only, that is God only, flesh God. Isme beej hai. The Akashvani said, take out the seeds from the flesh which are there inside. Seeds, take out and put them in separate hot pots. filled with ghee and protect it. Close it, protect it. By doing this, you will get 60,000 sons. The 60,000 seeds are there in that flesh. So 60,000 sons you will get as ordained by Lord Shiva himself. So don't wail at this tragedy and all. You will be blessed with a lot of children. So Lomasji continued to Yudhishthira. After some time, there came forth 60,000 sons, grace of Lord Shiva only. Now, all of them were terrible in their actions, behavior, thinking, and they were ruthless in their actions. Bhayankar, absolutely no, terrible fellows, horrible. They were capable of traveling in space, see the Siddhi. And because their number is huge, they always used to go and criticize gods and give trouble to Devatas, Gandharva, Rakshasas. The huge number, now 60,000 fellows, who can attack them? These fellows used to go, only one agenda, breakfast kaake, niklo. Lunch time, vapas aajao, khao, aram karlo, phir sham ko jao, disturb everybody. Some people are the agenda, that own agenda. Gharo mein bhi aise hota hai, bahar mein aise hota hai. Gharo mein agenda kya hai? Breakfast tak shant hai. Khane ke baad shuru Mahabharata. Ye aisa, wo aisa, ye kaisa, aisa kyon kiya, kya bana rahe ho, kal lunch mein kya bana rahe ho, kyon bana rahe ho, ye sabji kyon lai hai, aap wo lana tha, kal bhi nahi laya. So, this old person will take food at 1 o'clock at 12:30 and baad mein blood will go into the stomach, so she sleeps or he sleeps. Both one person sleeps. Phir again jag jate 4 baje. Haan, chai pilao, kaafi lao, munching ke liye kuch lao, murku lao, wala to namkeen lao. And khaake phir shuru. Ye aisa, wo aisa. फिर डिनर तक चलता है काम. डिनर में डिनर खा के थोड़ा नींद लगता है ना, तब टीवी के सामने बैठते हैं. वहां पे भी झगड़ा, मुझे ये चैनल देखना है, तो बदलते क्यों, बदलना नहीं, मैं ये देखना चाहती हूँ, वो देख. रात को तब सोने तक ना शाम घर में शांति नहीं होती. सो दे आर कॉल्ड, हु आर दे, 60,000 वेराइटी. सो these are doing huge number, Sagaraputras, horrible fellows. All the gods went to Brahmaji. One after one challenge. What is this happening? Brahma said, all of you, along with all these people, go back to your places. Don't come and disturb my routine work. In office, mein hartal gartal nahi chalta hai. In few days from now, they all will be destroyed together. Because they would commit a mistake. With that mistake, they will be killed. At once, wholesale destruction hoga, tab tak intezar raho. Have patience. After some time, King Sagara took Diksha to perform Aśvamedha Yajna. His Yajna horse protected by all his sons, 61 sons protected by that horse, protected by them, and he was roaming freely, the horse was roaming. When this horse had reached the shore of the ocean, Ganga Sagar, you know, all those places, it disappeared suddenly. The place where Ganga Sagar is there, no? How many of you have seen? Theek hai. Koi haath ante hota hai. Ek, do, one, two people turn. Theek hai, theek, one, two. Ganga Sagar. It doesn't mean that I will take you, huh? Acha kab yatra, it is not my intention, only to know, that's all. Ek thoda kujli hua puchne ke liye puch liya. So that's the place. So there horse went and disappeared. That time there was no ocean, no Ganga, place I am talking, disappeared ashram. Sagara putras went and report to their father saying, daddy, Someone stole our yajna ashva, yajnashva. Stolen by somebody. His father said, search for the horse everywhere, forest mein, mountain ranges mein, ocean, I mean nadiyon mein, jo bhi jahan jahan paani hai, har jagah, dhundo. In islands also, all the 60,000 people divided themselves into different search groups, and after thorough search, they all met in one place. Pahunch gaye, yahan se gaye, yahan sab mil gaye, beech mein, but they could not find the horse. Mila kya? Nahi mila. Mila kya? Nahi mila. They went to father, dad, we covered everything what you said, but we could not found the horse, nor the person who stolen, who had stolen it. We could not find. We are done. His Sagara became very angry and said, go and never return. Jao, fir kabhi laut ke mat aana. Find out the horse again. Without bringing the horse, don't come back. Pehla kya bola? Go and never return. Bas. So listening to father's sister instructions, what to do, they again start searching the horse. One place they found like a tunnel into the earth. Uh, tunnel mein ghus gaye sabhi log. Ye kahan jata hai? And Sagarputra started going into the depth of the ocean bed, actually deep, by digging a deep tunnel, and they came across many asuras, nagas, rakshasas and different animals. They tortured them. All the beings are suffering, wailing in pain because of their misbehavior. Then Sagarputras went towards northeastern side of the ocean. Northeastern only, na? Ganga Sagar. Of that, and rip open the patala, and inside, somewhere deep, they saw the horse. And there was Kapila Muni seated happily, shining in his own glory, performing tapas. Putras, Sagarputras excited seeing the horse, but they filled with anger also, and in excitement, went towards the horse to take the horse without even asking Maharshi anything. So Kapila Maharshi got angry. And bas, ek bar aankh khol ke dekha, instantly burnt. All 60,000 of them, electric crematorium. But electric crematorium mein time lagta hai na. Yahan pe time nahi hai, super electric hai. Powerful. Aankh khola, bas nikla. Ashes. Abhi dekho, who knows the news? Naraji dekhte hai na. Naraji pahuncha hai kabar. Maharaj, aapke beta aisa ho gaya. Aisa hua. Sagar was shocked. Tab unko yaad aaya Bhagwan Shiv ji ka. To bataya to hai. Bataya, Bhagwan to bata diya. Then, Sagar, how to get the horse back? He called his grandson, that is son. What is son's name? Asamanjasa. Samanjasa nahi, Asamanjasa. The son also bevkuf nikla actually. Samanjasa nahi hai, Asamanjasa. Nothing samanjasa. Nothing appropriate, proper. Everything improper, teda. Iska naam Asamanjasa. So Asamanjas ka kya hua? Main bata deta hu abhi Asamanjas ka. But Asamanjas son by name Anushuman. He called grandson and told, beta, mere baat to suno. Kya hua? All my 60,000 children, your chachas, were burned in the fire of anger of Kapila Maharshi. Sab log mar gaye. Now, मेरे पास तो तुम्हारा पिता तो अभी नहीं है. Why? I renounced your father also long back. मैंने उनको त्याग दिया. I kicked him out of, त्याग दिया माने kicked him out of the house. That's all. What did I do? Why? Because for the good of the kingdom, citizens in the kingdom, for their benefit, for good of the public, I had to give up my son. Sagara said. To protect the dharma, I had to give up my son. Yudhishthira ji asked, Maharaj, ye to bataiye ki unhone, why did he renounce, give up his son? Asamanjasa? Acha, please tell me. So Bhagavan, Lomash Rashish, Asamanjasa was born through Saibhya, we told that. He used to go to children outside, in the Rajame, Jana Bache playing Kiltaretana, Maidanme, Unkepas Jana, throttle their throats and throw them into the river. Now you see maniac people. Either me, tabhi bhi hai, abhi bhi hai. So nothing to surprise. कलयुग आ गया, कलयुग आ गया, ये सब बेवकूफ बकवास बंद करके अपना जो काम करना है काम करिए, बस जो कुछ कर सकते हैं आप करो. सिंपली टॉकिंग यू नो, दैट वे आई लाइक अवर गुरुजी स्टैंड पॉइंट, वेरी क्लियर. जो हमारे द्वारा हो सकता है वो करो. ज़्यादा यू नो चिल्लाना पिल्लाना ये वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम. व्हाट कैन यू डू? So your influence is, whatever the influence is there, to that influential circle, you teach good things. You are not prime minister, president, or prime minister to take decisions. And even you become prime minister, ministers will not listen to you. No minister will listen to you. Sab apna apna agenda leke bante hain. So it's not possible. Parivartan aana chahiye logon mein. Knowledge is only key, education is only means. So he used to throttle their throats, and all the citizens, they were scared. Ye kya raja ka putra aisa karta hai? Children are being killed everywhere, and they went to raja and said, Maharaj, hamara aap to raja hai, rakshak hai, you have to protect us. So bahut soch liya, soch vichar karke raja ne, he ordered his ministers to send his son out of the kingdom immediately. Jao Raja se bahar, Bhaiskaranam. It's called Raja Bhaiskaranam. So that is how Asamanjasa went out of kingdom. Ab bacha kaun hai? Ab koi nahi hai. Tu bacha hai, pota. Ek ek ne ek Asamanjas nikla aur baaki 60,000 bevakoof nikle. Mera prarabdh dekho. To isiliye. Now, my dear son, after Sagara told to Anshuman, dear son, I am in grief now. I am in sorrow, full condition. Because I gave your father, rest all of my sons having died, horse also lost, I am in deep crisis now. So please bring the horse, tumi ja sakte ho, and protect me from falling into hell. Hell means self-created. Isliye poochte hai na marne se pehle, what is your last wish? Huh? Last wish? Huh? Sunne bhi nahi aata. The story Mahatma is always to tell, no? He has four sons, businessmen. And a बाप ने ना बीमार पड़ गए, मरने वाला ही है एक घंटे दो घंटे में, तो कबर पहुंचा दिया चारों को. बेचारे चारों बाप को देखने के लिए आखिरी बार आगे खड़े हो गए राउंड, ऐसा देखा, एल्डेस्ट सन, सेकंड सन, थर्ड सन, फोर्थ सन. फिर बोला, आप चारों यहाँ पे आए तो दुकान में कौन रहेगा? बेवकूफ करके मर गए. अब लाओ, हाँ, नारा, यू नो, नारा या नारा, नारा इज आल्सो वाटर्स एक्चुअली. तेलुगु में भी नारा मीन्स यू नो दैट कोकोनट, दैट वो निकलता है ना, नार बोलते हैं उसको, नार, नार बोलते हैं हिंदी ना. तो एक बूढ़ा मरने वाला है, उसको कैसे तो भी नारा है ना बोलवाना उनसे. तो किसी ने, ठीक है नार लाके उनके मुंह पे रख देंगे, कम से कम बोलेगा नारा नारा, कम से कम नारायण में नार तो आ जाएगा, कम से कम मोक्ष तो कितना मिलेगा. तो डाल दिया उनके मुंह पे, ऑन द फेस. ही नेवर सेड नार, यू सेड ये क्या बकवास चीज बेवकूफ चीज ऊपर रखते हैं मरने समय में आसानी से मरने नहीं देते शांति से मरने नहीं देते निकालो करके हट गए मर गए मीनिंग इवन टाइम ऑफ डेथ स्मृति इज डिफिकल्ट दैट वे महात्मा गांधी शॉट डेड हे राम इंदिरा गांधी वो शॉट डेड ये क्या कर रहे हो the difference tapas yogi so my dear son go and protect me from the falling hell otherwise you know the desire will be left marne ke baad bhi yamaraj puchega ki sab theek hai mera ghoda main puchunga wahan pe bhi so anshuman reached that place where uncles all chachas were killed there he saw the horse as well as kapila maharshi first he prostrated at the feet of kapila maharshi gave him Then he praised him, I mean, stuti kiya. Then Kapila Muni was very happy. Said, ask for a boon. Ek pucho mango, var mango. Then said, please free the horse. And also bless me that all Pritrus, my Pritrus should be freed from, all 60,000 people should be freed from hell. Kapila Maharshi said, my dear Anshuman, You are endowed with all good virtues. Good virtues are there in you. Blessed is your father to have you as his son. Who? Asamanjasa. Asamanjasa ke ghar pet se samanjas nikla. It is again due to your goodness that all the dead uncles have gone to heaven. Mane? Marg par hai. There is no doubt about it. They go to heaven. So your grandson That is Anshuman's grandson. Sagara, Asamanjasa, Anshuman, Anshuman's grandson, Anshuman's sons and son. He is Bhagirath. Will please Lord Shiva and he would bring Gangaji from heaven to the earth. Heaven means from unmanifested plane to he would manifest the water again in a plenty of water onto the earth. It's not easy. To bring that. So you take your horse. Now may God be with you. May Paramatma bless you karke. Kapila Muni said. Sagara's yajna was completed in a grand way. Having heard that the yajnashva came back to him, Sagara renounced all his sorrow born out of son's death. You know, bache mar gaye wo dukh hai na. Goda wapas aa gaya yajna poorn hua. Shanti mili unko. Then Anshuman's son's name was Dilip Chakravarti, Dilip, King Dilip, Raja Dilip, great, Raja Dilip, he was a great Mahatma, Dharmatma. Anshumanji left for the sapas only after giving his kingdom to his son Dilipa and Dilipa's son was Bhagiratha. So, it's all history. So millions of years back. So Dilipa, he heard, first Anshuman's son only, Dilipa heard about the story of his Pitrus, that my father went and then brought back the horse. And he made a great attempt to bring down that Ganges from the heaven. Great attempt, great tapas. And tapas was incomplete. Dilipa was blessed with a son by name Bhagiratha. In the end, Dilip Raja also made Bhagiratha as a king and he left for forest for tapas. Chala gaya. After leaving the body, Dilip Maharaj Chakravarti ascended to heaven. Higher planes. When Bhagirath ji heard about his Pitrus, he felt very bad. That you know, Sagara, Sagara's son, Asamanjasa, Asamanjasa's son, Anshuman, Anshumasan, Dilipa, Dilipasan, Bhagiratha. So Bhagirathi. Now, he felt very bad. So what did he do? He handed over his kingdom to minister. Deputed. Mantri Loku Devi Raj and he left for Himalayas for tapas. What was the intention? To purify himself first with his tapas and then start worshipping Gangaji.
beautiful. First, without our purification, directly we attack gods only. Bhagavan darshanudho. Bhagavan bolte darshan doonga pehle to apna aate hain. Dakkan shuddhi karke mujhse poocho ki turant main prakat ho jaunga. So he did, first he did tapas to purify himself. So he was in tapas for many years, thousands of years it is mentioned. Many very intense tapas. After 1000 divine years, Gangaji gave darshan to Bhagirathji. So a lot of tapas he did. Ganga said, Beta, bolo, what do you want from me? What do I give you? Whatever you want, I will fulfill your desire. Please tell me. Bhagirathji told the entire story to her. Dekho, aisa hua. So mere purvi lo, pitrus were killed. They are to be purified. They have to go and the higher planes. So till you don't wet them, sprinkle them, your waters of your waters don't touch their burnt bodies there, they don't be liberated. So please make sons of the Sagara Chakravarti reach heaven. I beg you for their upliftment. You must help them. Ganga said, okay, I will descend, I agree with you. But when I fall from space, it is difficult to stop my speed. I descend with a high power of manifestation. Suddenly, like for example, I'm not exaggerating, a proper example. Something you see, something which grows in seconds, they grow and multiply. Some cells are there. Within seconds they multiply and you cannot attack them so easily. Certain virus is there. Similarly, positive thoughts also are there, certain thoughts. Suddenly they multiply in a good number and it will uplift you. Similarly, Gangaji, with the intensity with which, the speed with which the manifestation of Gangaji takes place, Gangaji planned, he said, nobody can't withstand the speed of it. When I descend from the subtle to gross level, the speed has to be withdrawn, I mean withstood. So, other than Lord Shiva, no one can withstand my speed. So, through your tapas again, please Lord Shiva, when I descend, he can hold me in his hair, jatajutu. He can hold me, then I can slowly come out. So, ye to Bhagira ji dekhi kitna tap kiya. Pahle apne shuddhi ke tap kiya. Baad mein Ganga ji ke tap. Baad mein Shiva ji ke liye tap kiya. Then he went to Kailash mountain. Again started tapas there for Lord Shiva. Then after some time, Lord Shiva gave darshan. He asked Shiva, aisa hone wala hai, Gangaji, you must hold on your head and help the Gangaji descend onto the plains on this earth. So Shiva assured Bhagiratha that he will hold the Ganga in his head. So theek hai, I will do it. So then Bhagiratha prayed to Gangaji to descend. Now Shivaji is ready. Kindly descend. Avatarate. Avatara. Avatar. Gangaji saw Bhagwan Shankarji standing there. Opened up all his locks and standing and looking at the photos is there, must have seen. Painting, artist painting. He was standing there, then in the Himalayan mountains and waiting to hold her in his hair, matted locks, or unruffled, totally untied. So she started descending. And during Ganga's descent, all the Gandharvas, Naga, Yaksha, all of them came round to see the witness this great Ganga's descent. And descended, she descended. Bhagavan Shiva heard in her hairs, that is the avatar of Ganga. So, Bolo Ganga Maya ki jai. First step she descended. Jnana Ganga. Okay. Now, after that, Gangaji divided herself into three streams. In some places, she is Sarpa Sharirini, moving like a, in a coiled path. Crooked courses in the Himalayas. At some places, she jumps and falls at once from heights. Boom! Huge quantity of water. And some places, she flows in a serene way
emanating music from its movement, Ghosha. Gangaji's Ghosha. That Ghosha you can see in our Uttarakash. And in Gomukh, but descent, boom, falls. And wherever the falls are there, you can see the falls. Otherwise, entire ranges sometimes, you can see this path of Gangaji. So see three different streams, varieties of expressions are there. And she reached earth and sent to King Bhagiratha, show me now direction, which direction I should move now, tell me. So Bhagiratha was leading Gangaji, Gangaji was following. And Bhagiratha led her to the place where Pitrus died, there that Ganga Sagar. He went to the ocean and filled the ocean with waters of Ganga. That was a great completion and Gangaji is blessed. So Bhagiratha, after filling that entire thing, he gave Jaladan to his Pitrus and he felt very happy. And Ganga thus descended on the earth to only fill the oceans again. Apuryamanam achalapratishtam samudrama apapravishanti yadvatam. That example also beautiful in Bhagavad Gita we see. Now, Vaishampanji continues. After listening to all these stories, Yudhishthira went forward, covering few other Tirtha Kshetras. He saw Nanda Devi River and Aparananda. From there he went to Hemakuta Parvat. And saw, he noticed a beautiful, wonderful phenomenon there. What was the phenomenon in Hemakuta Parvat? I don't know, it may be Hemakunda, I don't know. Hemakunda Parvat was sakta patana, Hemakuta pataya. Might be the place where our Hemakunda and then. Nanakji tapasam. So that place. Might be, I don't know. Hemakuta Parvata. And there, when he went to Himalayas only. Now, because they are going towards Himalayas only. Mahape jaye, he saw a phenomenon there. What? There were many stones rolling down. Landslides he saw. Huge boulders rolling down from there. Then those who are filled with grief and sorrow, it is said here in Mahābhārata, Vaishamani says that those who are filled with dukkha and grief and sorrow in themselves, they can never climb this mountain. It is even now it is true. Hai ki nahi? Maha pe jana? Hemkund sahab? Bahut mushkil hai. Hemkund sahab, yahan tak hatta market jate hain, we will complain. Hemkund sahab tak jane ki jaya jurta hai. We are evolved now. Hatta market tak jake dekhe aao, maja aayega aapko. Traffic mein, you will be so restless. So sorrow you carry, you know, you can't go to hatta market also. So impossible to climb. And they cannot stand. Nature is different, weather, so many things. And there used to be rain every day. Mahabharata, that mountain, everywhere rain. And he used to listen, Yudhishthira was listening to Vedic chantings, but the chanters are not visible. Suntete ki Veda Gosha. Who is chanting? I don't know. And it is very clear, mentioned very beautiful, on these mountains, there are many mosquitoes which disturb the tapas of sadhus. And due to all this, because of this, people develop dispassion towards that place and remember their houses, I believe. Mahavartam diya hai. Maha jane ke baad ghar yaad aata hai sabko. Bhagawan nahi. Ghar. Abhi bhi correct hai ki nahi? Chalo jaldi lautte hai aaram. Ho to gaya Bhagawan ka darshan. Baar baar kaun jate hai? Ek baar to aarti ho gaye, bas ho gaye. So, as you know, we are released from the pressure of darshan. Aisa anubhav hota hai. You release your bowel pressure. Let's say you go. Hey, darshan ho gaya, subah aarti ho gaya. Haan, Bhagawan ka darshan ho gaya. Chalo, lautte hai, pack karo, pack karo. Actually, that relief is that you had darshan.
पता नहीं क्या कम्युनिकेट किया भगवान से, क्या हुआ, कुछ मिला, प्रसाद तो मिला और क्या चाहिए, चलो 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 चलो. सो दैट इज द वे इट इज अवर माइंड वर्क्स देयर. आफ्टरवर्ड्स हाँ, ऑब्जर्विंग ऑल दिस, युधिष्ठिर आस्क्ड ए क्वेश्चन टू लोमश महाराज, व्हाट इज द रीजन फॉर ऑल सच फिनोमेनन ऑन दिस माउंटेन्स, ये सच क्या क्या फिनोमेनन हो रहा है यहाँ पे. देन लोमश सेड, आई विल टेल यू एज वी हैव हर्ड इन द पास्ट, हमें सुनने के लिए आया था तो हम वही बोलेंगे, बताएंगे आपको. लिसन टू मी विद फुल अटेंशन. क्या ऑन ऋषभ कूट देयर यूज्ड टू बी ए तपस्वी बाय नेम ऋषभ, ऑन दोज रेंजेस ऋषभ ए मुनि, हिज एज वॉज अबव 100 ईयर्स, यूज्ड टू डू तपस. ही वॉज ए तपस्वी बट ऑल्सो वेरी एंग्री, क्रोध स्वभाव, बहुत क्रोधी है, बड़ा क्रोधी. When others tried to talk to him or reach him, he did not like this. कोई पहुंचा था, he doesn't want. So what it is, he asked the mountain, whoever talks here, you must roll stones on them. औली बोलते हैं ना हिंदी में, गिरा दो. So whenever you go and start talking and shouting and all, पत्थर गिरते हैं. And he called Vayudev also. He said, look, here there should not be any noise of any kind. He ordered Vayu. Hava ka, no noise. He ordered Vayu. So peaceful, absolute peaceful. And so when any man talks, he stopped from talking by a roaring cloud. So pure atmosphere, clouds roar, and thus Rishabha Rishi brought many changes here. It was his sankalpa. We also heard that in the past gods visited this place and many wanted to have their darshan, but they don't want anyone to see them, nothing. Hence they made this mountain unsurmountable to ordinary person. It became difficult. वो युधिष्ठिर जी यहां तक पहुंचना, आप तो पहुंच गए तो ठीक है. दोज हु हैव नॉट डन एनी तपस, दे कांट इवन सी दिस माउंटेन, इज इट नॉट ट्रू. वो अंदर पड़ा है ना, हेमकोट पर्वत एंड ऑल दैट समवेयर हियर, एंड फॉरगेट अबाउट क्लाइंबिंग इज इट, देखना भी नहीं होता है, डोंट टॉक अबाउट क्लाइंबिंग नाउ. इवन टूडे हियर ऋषिस एंड देवतास रिसाइड, यू वुड हियर देयर चांटिंग्स इन द मॉर्निंग एज वेल एज इन द इवनिंग. They are the chanting, people who chant. So Kunti Nandana, you take bath in this Nanda Tirtha and all sins will be destroyed at once. After this, Yudhishthira reached Kaushiki and afterwards everything was going on very well. And Lomash Maharshi says, this is the river Kaushiki and here it is Vishwamitra's ashram. Here, there is also an ashram belonging to Mahatma Vibhandaka. This story is very interesting. We will see tomorrow. Mahatma Vibhandaka, by name Punya, Rishyasringa Muni is Vibhandaka's son. So, we will take up this story of Vibhandaka. Great story of a Rishi Vibhandaka by name Mahatma Vibhandaka. That we can take up tomorrow. I say, jaun, aur badhaun speed. ठीक है, ठीक है. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरिः ओम सद्गुरुणां महाराजे जय.